Haganoy Market Vendors Association v. Mun of Haganoy. Facts: on October 1, 1996, the Sangguniang Bayan of Haganoy, Bulacan, enacted an ordinance, Code Usan BLG 28, which increased the stall rentals of the market vendors in Haganoy. Article 3 provided that it shall take effect upon approval. The subject ordinance was posted from November 4 to 25, 1996. In the last week of November, 1997, the petitioner's members were personally given copies of the approved ordinance and were informed that it shall be enforced in January, 1998. On December 8, 1997, the petitioner's president filed an appeal with the Secretary of Justice assailing the constitutionality of the tax ordinance. Petitioner claimed it was unaware of the posting of the ordinance. Respondent opposed the appeal. It contended that the ordinance took effect on October 6, 1996 and that the ordinance, as approved, was posted as required by law. Hence, it was pointed out that petitioner's appeal, made over a year later, was already time-barred. The Secretary of Justice dismissed the appeal on the ground that it was filed out of time, i.e., beyond 30 days from the effectivity of the ordinance on October 1, 1996, as prescribed under Section 187 of the 1991 Local Government Code. Issue 1. The CA erred in dismissing the appeal held yes ratio. We find that the Court of Appeals erred in dismissing petitioner's appeal on the ground that it was formally deficient. It is clear from the records that the petitioner exerted due diligence to get the copies of its appealed resolutions certified by the Department of Justice, but failed to do so on account of Typhoon Laling. Under the circumstances, respondent appellate court should have tempered its strict application of procedural rules in view of the fortuitous event, considering that litigation is not a game of technicalities. Issue 1. The petitioner should be dismissed held yes ratio. The petition should be dismissed as the appeal of the petitioner with the Secretary of Justice is already time barred. The applicable law is Section 187 of the 1991 Local Government Code. The law requires that an appeal of a tax ordinance or revenue measure should be made to the Secretary of Justice within 30 days from effectivity of the ordinance and even during its pendency. The effectivity of the assailed ordinance shall not be suspended. In the case at bar, Municipal Ordinance No. 28 took effect in October 1996. Petitioner filed its appeal only in December 1997. More than a year after the effectivity of the ordinance in 1996. Clearly, the Secretary of Justice correctly dismissed it for being time-barred. At this point, it is apropos to state that the timeframe fixed by law for parties to avail of their legal remedies before competent courts is not a mere technicality that can be easily brushed aside. The periods stated in Section 187 of the Local Government Code are mandatory. Ordinance No. 28 is a revenue measure adopted by the municipality of Haganoy to fix and collect public market stall rentals. Being its lifeblood, collection of revenues by the government is of paramount importance. The funds for the operation of its agencies and provision of basic services to its inhabitants are largely derived from its revenues and collections. Thus, it is essential that the validity of revenue measures is not left uncertain for a considerable length of time. Hence, the law provided a time limit for an aggrieved party to assail the legality of revenue measures and tax ordinances. In a last-ditch effort to justify its failure to file a timely appeal with the Secretary of Justice, the petitioner contends that its period to appeal should be counted not from the time the ordinance took effect in 1996 but from the time its members were personally given copies of the approved ordinance in November 1997. It insists that it was unaware of the approval and effectivity of the subject ordinance in 1996 on two grounds. First, no public hearing was conducted prior to the passage of the ordinance and, second, the approved ordinance was not posted. We do not agree. Petitioner's bold assertion that there was no public hearing conducted prior to the passage of Code Usan BLG 28 is belied by its own evidence. In petitioner's two communications with the Secretary of Justice, it enumerated the various objections raised by its members before the passage of the ordinance in several meetings called by the Sangguniang for the purpose. These show beyond doubt that petitioner was aware of the proposed increase and in fact participated in the public hearings therefore. The respondent municipality likewise submitted the minutes and report of the public hearings conducted by the Sangguniang Bayan's Committee on Appropriations and Market on February 6, July 15, and August 19, all in 1996. For the proposed increase in the stall rentals, petitioner cannot gripe that there was practically no public hearing conducted as its objections to the proposed measure were not considered by the Sangguniang Bayan. To be sure, public hearings are conducted by legislative bodies to allow interested parties to ventilate their views on a proposed law or ordinance. These views, however, are not binding on the legislative body and it is not compelled by law to adopt the same. Sangguniang members are elected by the people to make laws that will promote the general interest of their constituents. They are mandated to use their discretion and best judgment in serving the people. Parties who participate in public hearings to give their opinions on a proposed ordinance should not expect that their views would be patronized by their lawmakers. On the issue of publication or posting, the records is bereft of any evidence to prove petitioner's negative allegation that the subject ordinance was not posted as required by law. In contrast, the respondent Sangguniang Bayan of the municipality of Haganoy, Bulacan, presented evidence which clearly shows that the procedure for the enactment of the assailed ordinance was complied with. Municipal Ordinance No. 28 was enacted by the Sangguniang Bayan of Haganoy on October 1, 1996. Then Acting Municipal Mayor Maria Garcia Santos approved the ordinance on October 7, 1996. After its approval, copies of the ordinance were given to the municipal treasurer on the same day. On November 9, 1996, the ordinance was approved by the Sangguniang Panlalawigan. The ordinance was posted during the period from November 4 to 25, 1996 in three public places, viz. In front of the municipal building, at the bulletin board of the Sta Ana Parish Church and on the front door of the office of the market master in the public market. Posting was validly made in lieu of publication as there was no newspaper of local circulation in the municipality of Haganoy. This fact was known to and admitted by petitioner. Thus, petitioner's ambiguous and unsupported claim that it was only sometime in November 1997 that the provincial board approved municipal ordinance number 28 and so the posting could not have been made in November 1996 was sufficiently disproved by the positive evidence of respondent municipality. Given the foregoing circumstances, petitioner cannot validly claim lack of knowledge of the approved ordinance. The filing of its appeal a year after the effectivity of the subject ordinance is fatal to its cause. Finally, even on the substantive points raised, the petition must fail. Section 6C.04 of the 1993 Municipal Revenue Code and Section 191 of the Local Government Code limiting the percentage of increase that can be imposed apply to tax rates, not rentals. Neither can it be said that the rates were not uniformly imposed or that the public markets included in the ordinance were unreasonably determined or classified. To be sure, the ordinance covered the three concrete public markets, the two-story Baygong Paylink, the burnt but reconstructed Lumang Paylink and the more recent Lumang Paylink with wet market. However, the Paylengkang Baygong Municipia or Gabaldon was excluded from the increase in rentals as it is only a makeshift, dilapidated place, with no doors or protection for security. Intended for transient peddlers who used to sell their goods along the sidewalk,